Hello. Good afternoon. Welcome back to Space Engineers here in the United Kingdom. Just as in the game, it's sunny outside. This is my very short look at mod.io. Now, as long as you've accepted the mod.io user agreement at the start of the game, it will have created a page on the Space Engineers mod.io site, which I'll leave in the link of the description of this video, for you to browse using your gamer tag. All the user creations that have appeared in Space Engineers so far, and also if you've got your own, you can upload them to mod.io, share them with people, or just keep a backup of your favourite builds. How to do it from within the game. I've covered how to blueprint a ship, and basically, once you've got a blueprint, you can open your blueprints page by holding down the right bumper and pressing B. You'll see that on this page there's a bunch of things. We're in the menu selection at the moment at the top that toggles between all cloud and mod.io blueprints. So at the moment, all means that every single thing, including the cloud, which are all the ships here that I've got saved on my actual console, and then things like the Timberwolf. This is a mod.io blueprint. You can tell usually because people tend to write a detailed description or some form of description. You'll see that this is Driller Bob 1.5 by Tater Poutine. Tater Poutine left me a very nice message here on their blueprint, so thank you very much for that. And if you want to bring in someone else's ship from mod.io, all you need to do is select that blueprint and press A. Now, you'll notice it's appeared in a pretty weird way. So what you want to do is you want to reorientate it by pressing right or left on the D-pad, and you can rotate it round. It's not going to be very happy if I paste it in upside down. That should just about do it. You can also hold the left bumper and you can reorientate the ship like this. There we go. By pressing left on the D-pad with the left bumper held. You'll see. You can make the blueprint further away. You can bring it closer by pressing up and down. And when you're happy with the position, as long as the person who has blueprinted this has followed one of my rules, which is to ensure your thrusters are active when you blueprint a ship, when you press the right trigger, it will hover in place. And then it's in your world. All the controls are linked, thanks to Keen for fixing that particular issue. And Driller Bob is functional. Okay, but say you didn't want Driller Bob. I mean, you could easily get rid of it just pressing the right stick. And you'll see options. You can make another copy of Driller Bob. You can create a blueprint from Driller Bob, or you can cut Driller Bob. This will make a copy of it as well, but it'll also remove it from the world. So let's go back to the blueprint menu, right bumper and B. And now let's have a look at the workshop. So all you need to do is press the three lines and browse workshop. Now you can search by various criteria, but what we want to do is we want to look for one of names here, see whether or not Glenn has put this up by its proper name. Aha! and see Red Dwarf Ballistic Cruiser, aka the Gungnir. Now, I can't have that in my world at the moment until I press A. That toggles my subscription to the Gungnir. So if I go back to my mod page and scroll through, it's a mod IO ship, so it will appear in the list where there's mod IO ships, but notice it's not there. Simply press Y. And if Space Engineers is behaving itself, somewhere on your list, you should find it. If not, you might have to come out of the blueprint menu and go back in. This is the thing with the Mod IO Workshop. You can also try searching. Can press reload all blueprint scripts and refresh the list. Let's put the now, did I confirm it? It should be there. There are some issues at the moment with the workshop, though. Let's see if we can bring in another ship, the EV1 Cardova. I'm going to say, this being a live demonstration, there's the Cardova. So for some reason it didn't like bringing the Gungnir in, but the Cardova is there. So if you want to look at the Cardova, we press A and we wait for the game to stream it in world. Same thing. You can orientate this till it's facing the correct way. What a nice looking ship. You can change the axis of rotation by pressing down on the D-pad. So you can pitch yaw and balance it how you want. And if I paste it in, if they haven't blueprinted this with the thrusters active, it's going to hit the deck hard. So now we wait for the game to stream it in. But they've been great, and they have pasted this in with the thrusters active. Quality. I like the design of that. Very nice. I'll be definitely looking at that one a bit later on. For now though. So we open the blueprint menu up again. And yep. Don't see the Red Dwarf there. So there may be some issue with its version. I'm not sure. As I said, these things are right, let's try making sure that we've got it exactly. I may have deselected it and forgot to reselect it again. That could also be the problem. In which case, these are just some of the problems you can run into when you're using mod IO. But as you could see from previous example, I was able to bring the Cardover in from the workshop. But it's obvious it doesn't want me to bring in the Gungnir. Even though I've refreshed the blueprints and subscribed to it. That is strange. Other ships though seem to be fine. I was able to bring some of my own things in from mod.io. And look at things like the Timberwolf. So, just once again, browse your workshop. Take a look at the thing you want. Subscribe to it. Head back. Press Y. Wait a bit. And there. Press A. Take a look. Another nice design. Getting a kind of Star Wars feel from that one. If they've been good and they've activated the thrusters, when I paste this in with the right trigger, it won't drop to the deck. That's another ship. And that's really just a quick look at mod.io, how to get other people's creations and your own into mod.io. I have covered how to publish on mod.io before now, but if you need a brief refresher, nip over to my ship, the Century Eagle. Now, we've already got a blueprint, so we don't need to worry about that, but you can click the right stick in, choose copy grid or create blueprint. If you've already got a blueprint, you'll need to do a copy grid action. And when you've got a copied grid, open up your blueprints menu and let's sort this into the cloud. There's my version of the Century Eagle. And what you need to do is replace the blueprint with your grid that you've just copied and then hit publish. This will take you to a new menu. You can choose what type, whether it's a ship, a base, a rover, and then you should be able to publish it. It'll be on mod.io then for all to see. You can go onto the PC version, or you can open the item in workshop and adjust a lot of description. You can write reams of lore on the ship if you want. That's pretty much my tutorial on mod.io and some of the issues you can have with it. Obviously, it seems it does not like the Gungnir blueprint. Could be because it needs updating to a new version of the game. So that's it. That's all from me for now. I will be streaming again at some point. I shall probably eventually do a nice little relaxed, very early survival series. It won't be too heavily focused on getting optimal production. It'll just be focused on getting you out of the pod and into enough industry to keep yourself going, what you do first. And how I like to do things. Like Splitzy, he likes to turn his mining pod, or rather his landing pod, into a miner. I would rather build a miner from scratch, given half a chance. So I will cover grinding down parts of the pod. I'm not sure whether or not I want to use the progression system yet or not. Leave a comment if you think I should do it right from the get-go with default settings and have progression enabled. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Cheers. Stay safe, take care, happy engineering, bye-bye.